Welcome everyone and thank you for joining me for a demo of Swanly, Project Portfolio Roadmap app for Jira Cloud. Swanly is a great Jira app that allows you to create roadmaps across your Jira projects, track high-level progress reports of your key activities, and also allows you to create release timeline and reports without too much fuss, setting up or need for training before you start using the app. Swanly is a great, less pricey alternative to Jira Advanced Roadmaps that are available on Jira Premium Plan. You can also use Swanly to create any types of plans, be it software delivery, release management, project management, or even marketing planning, product management, or event planning. Swanly's simple UI makes it easy to pick up by any teams, even the ones that don't have as much technical or project management background. Okay, so let's have a look at demo of Swanly. First things first, after you install the app from the Atlassian Marketplace, you can find the app in two locations in your Jira. The first one is under the apps on your main navigation menu, where you can find the roadmaps in the dropdown. When you are accessing Swanly from here, you can use it as a portfolio project management tool. You would be able to see issues or releases from across multiple projects and manage them from a single place. There is also an option to access Swanly here from the project menu. Keep in mind that if you access Swanly from the project menu, the data will be filtered by that particular project, so you would only see the issues or releases from that one project. So before I go into the details of Swanly and how it can help you, let's have a look at Swanly's main views. Swanly comes with two main views, issue and release view. The difference between these two views is what kind of activities you can schedule on your timeline and create the reports for. In the issue view, you can manage and schedule issues from your Jira, be it epics, stories, tasks, subtasks, or any custom issue types that you have. And in the release view, you are scheduling releases, aka fixed versions, on the roadmap and generating reports for these. There are also two ways you can view your project's data in Swanly. You can either visualize activities on the roadmap, or you can see them in the list view. When you access the app for the first time, the first thing you need to do is to decide what kind of projects you would like to work with and import them in Swanly. You can do that under the issue settings and then import project. If you would like to remove project in the future and not see it in Swanly anymore, you can also do it from here. After you import projects in the issue view, if you're already using a start date and due date fields in Jira for your issues, for example, if you are already using the Jira project level roadmap, you would already be able to see issues on the Swanly roadmap. If you are not using these fields, you can schedule the issues from the plus add issue panel, either by clicking on the schedule button and selecting the start or end date, or you can simply drag and drop the issue on the roadmap. When you are creating your roadmap, you will notice that your roadmap has swim lanes and issues appear as colorful lines as activities. By default, each swim lane means the project, but you can always change that. There is a group by button where you can select either group by project, template, status category, or assignee. There are more of these group by options coming soon, for example, components, fixed versions, releases, sprints, and project categories. If you would like to customize your view a little bit further, you can use filters to filter the data on the roadmap. You can filter by project, templates, status category, issue type, or assignee. But you can also use the search if you would like to filter out the issues from the roadmap based on the search query. There is also an option to color your activities on the roadmap. The default coloring is the one that you can manually select for your issue and it's stored in the issue color field. You can change the color of the issue by clicking on it and selecting the color from the issue report view. But if you don't want to color issues manually, you can also do that automatically based on status category, where you would see the open issues in gray, in progress issues in blue, and done issues in green. And any issues that are flagged are red, so you can see them immediately. There is also a coloring option by project or by a template. These three customization options for your roadmap are very powerful. You can customize your view exactly to your own needs with the filters, grouping, and colors. For example, you can create an assignee roadmap to visualize who is working on what and when across projects. You probably noticed that when you are scheduling your issues on the roadmap, you would see everything in this flat view. So your epics are on the same level as the stories and subtasks and so on. If you would like to see the issues in the hierarchical view, you can use this hierarchy button where you can select the hierarchy level. For example, epics can be on the top of the hierarchy, and then you would be able to see epics on your roadmap first, and then you expand them to see their stories, and you can also expand these stories to see the scheduled subtasks for this particular stories. There are also options for zooming in and out, so you can zoom in to the daily view, weekly, monthly, quarterly, or even yearly. So the options for zooming are quite flexible, and it just depends on how low level or high level you want your plans to be, and choose the appropriate zoom level. And last but not least, there's also an option to export this roadmap. You just select the start and end date, and the roadmap will be exported in the PNG format with the filters, grouping, and coloring that you set up here on this view. So you can export this roadmap and then, for example, include it in your presentation or share it externally. Now let's have a look at these reports that Swanly generates for you. When you click on Issue on the roadmap, you will be able to see the Issue Report panel. In this report panel, you can find high-level information about the issue, like its summary, status, project, assignee, template, start and end date, and so on. And this information is also editable, so you can, for example, quickly change the status of the issue, and you don't need to access Jira for that. But you can also see the high-level information about how this particular issue is progressing. For example, if you have this epic, the epic has a child issues that are delivering it. So in this case, it's stories and some tasks that are delivering this particular epic, and you can see them all in the child issues section over here. In terms of progress tracking, you can check the middle section where you can see the high level progress of these child issues based on the status category, which is done in progress and open. Or if you want to go a little bit lower level, you can have a look at the status breakdown as well. This is great when you want to see if issues are getting stuck in some particular status, like for example, review and so on. There is also a time tracking option if you are using time tracking that is available in Jira by default, which is the original estimate field, and then this time tracking field where you can look at the time you spent on the issue and the time remaining. Swanly works with this information and it summarizes it across all the child issues and shows you the high-level original estimate, how much time was done, in progress or overdue. There is also a story point sum up. You can see the high-level progress of your story points. The story points field is customizable. You can select any numeric field that you have in Jira to be considered in these reports. So be it complexity points, priority score, and so on, you can set it up. There is also a burndown chart where you can see the actual progress of your tasks over time. And you can choose to draw the burndown chart based on issue count, story points, or time tracking. You can also share this report. If you click here on the share button, you can share the URL with your teams so they can go and access this exact report. Just keep in mind that they need to have access to your Jira and Swanly in order to see them. You probably noticed this section over here called templates. Templates in Swanly allow you to create stages that can be used as a high-level milestones for your issue. You can track their status and visualize them on the roadmap. So if you want to, for example, track milestones or phases of your initiatives, you can use templates and stages for that. You can set up the templates here in the settings. For example, I have this MVP template where I have stages like research, sign off, delivering, and so on. Each of the phases can also have a default duration. If you already know how much time you are going to spend on each of these stages, you can fill it out here. The default duration is handy when you are scheduling your issues on the roadmap because it speeds up your planning process. When you want to schedule an issue using templates, click on Add Issue button and then Schedule. In this section, select the template that you would like to use, and then you can either select the start date or the end date. For example, if I know that I need to start this issue next week, I can select the start date, and then the end date will be automatically calculated together with all dates for all the stages based on the default duration that we set it up in the template. And once you schedule this issue, you would be able to see it scheduled on the roadmap together with its stages. You can also change the status of the stage from the issue detail. The stage can be either in progress, pending, failed, or done. If you would like to see your issues in the simple list, you can use List View in Swanly. Here you can see all issues from the projects that you imported. There are filters available for you to filter the information to get the right view. And there is also an option to see the issues in the hierarchy. If you want to quickly see how the issue is progressing, or you would like to do some quick changes, you can just click on the issue here and you can do the changes, or you can open ticket in Jira in this pop-up as well. So that's it for the issue view. Now let's have a quick look at the release view in Swanly. Release view works with fixed versions in Jira, which are releases that you can create and track in your Jira projects under the Releases tab. In Jira, by default, you can create the releases with the name, description, start, and end date, and you can assign these releases to your issues. And then you can track your issues and see in what release they were delivered. Releases also have a status, released and unreleased. So where Swanly comes into play is the visualization of these releases on the roadmap and creating release reports. With Swanly, you can create this cross-project release roadmap, and you can see the releases from across the projects in one single view. But you can also create something that is called cross-project release, which is a release that can be used across multiple projects in Jira. Let me show you how you can get started with the release view in Swanly. First things first, when you access this view, first thing that you need to do is to select the projects that you would like to work with. Now, imported projects in the release view can be different from the projects in the issue view. You can use these views independently. So for example, the marketing team can use the issue view and the product team can use the release view. So after you import your projects, you would be able to see the swim lanes already appearing as a project on the roadmap, and you'll be able to see the fixed versions as well as the activities if you already have some fixed versions in these projects with the start date and end date assigned. If you don't have any, then don't worry, you can quickly create and add the release from Swanly in the Add Release panel. Here you can create a completely new release, or you can schedule an existing release on the roadmap, either by drag and dropping them or clicking on the Schedule button and selecting the start and end date. You can filter the roadmap by the project, template, and release status, and you can also group it by project, release status, and template. You can color your releases to customize your roadmap view even more, and you can either select the color manually, or you can color them by status, project, or template. Swanly allows you to create the cross-project releases, which are releases that can be used across multiple projects. You can create a cross-project release from Add Release panel and select projects you want to include this release in the projects field. Once you create this release, Swanly creates a release in each selected project, and any changes done to these releases will be synchronized, so the release acts as one. For example, if someone would come and do the changes in the release name in one of the projects, then this update would be distributed to all other projects too. If you want to know how the release is progressing, you can have a look at cross-project release reports, where you can find all issues that are linked to this release, and you can see them all in one view. You can also track progress of the release either by status category of linked issues, statuses, or you can also see status category distributed per project. There is also an option to see the time tracking for the release. If you are using time tracking in Jira, you can either see it for the release as a whole or per project again. And the same comes for story points. There is a release burndown chart where you can track the progress of the release over time with three tracking options available, which are issue count, story points, and time estimate. There is an option to share this report, or you can generate the release notes either in HTML or text format. Releases also have stages and templates available, similar to issue templates. You can use these templates if you would like to, for example, categorize your releases as hot fixes, new product launches, bug fixes, or improvement releases. You can create these templates here, and you can also create stages with the default duration, so then it's much easier for you to schedule these releases and plan. A good thing about using templates is that if you are using the templates for different release types, you can group your roadmap by template and you would see different types of releases as a swim lanes, and you can also filter by them. So if you ever need to know how many hotfixes or improvement releases you've done in the last year, you would be able to easily visualize it. There is also an option to see releases in the list view if you would like to access and manage all releases from all imported projects in one place. You can do it from here. You can quickly find a release by using filters or search and open release detail by clicking on the release. From the detail view, you can quickly update the release status, name, description, and so on, and you can also quickly add the scope if needed. You can export this view if you would like to get the CSV export of all your releases in your Jira. Now, before we finish the demo, let's quickly talk about permissions in the app. There are 5 permissions available, 1 global permission and 4 on the project level. The global level permission is the administer Swanly permission that allows you to import any project in Swanly, create cross-project releases, set up templates, and use both views, issue and release. On the other hand, project level permissions allow you to only edit or view Swanly in the project where they are applied. And these permissions are also separate for issue view and release view, which means that you can, for example, give your release manager access to the release view in Swanly to edit, but only to view the data in the issue view or restricted access altogether. Swanly also works with Jira issue permission to make sure that no issues that user doesn't have access to aren't visible to them. You can read more about permissions in Swanly and how to set them up in our documentation, bk.jaxa.io. And that's about it for the demo. Usually we also do get questions about the security of our applications and pricing, so let me quickly answer your potential questions around that. Swanly is part of all Atlassian Marketplace security programs, including Cloud Fortified, Bug Bounty Program, Cloud Application Security Program, and Security Self-Assessment Program, including KaiQLED. As part of these programs, Swanly is being tested on a daily basis by independent security researchers to make sure that there aren't any security vulnerabilities in the application. We also run the regular automated checks on our apps to ensure they are up and running, and we have 24 hours SLA policy on our support, but we usually reply in less than 4 hours. Swanly doesn't store any personal information. The only contact your organization is registered is the technical contact that gets updates about our app. In terms of pricing, Swanly is a Jira app paid via Atlassian. It comes with at least 30 days free trial, and after that you will be billed for the app together with your Atlassian tools bill. Depending on how you pay for your Jira, you would also pay for Swanly, either monthly or yearly. And the app is also paid for all users that are in your Jira. To make sure that the bill isn't as high, for more users you get, the price per seat decreases. The app is also free for up to 10 users, so if you're a small company or you want to test the app in your own test environment, you can use it for as long as you need for free. Swanly is a great cheaper alternative to your Jira advanced roadmaps if you are looking for cross-project roadmapping solution. And that's about it. I hope that you enjoyed this demo of Swanly Project Portfolio Roadmap app for Jira Cloud. If you do have any question, you can always reach out to our support or check out our documentation on wiki.jaxa.io. Have a great day and happy planning!